Steve Dotto here. How the heck are you this fine day? Me? I'm feeling particularly well connected, and thank you so much for asking. Why is it I'm feeling so well connected, you might well ask? I'm glad you did, because I would like to tell you. It's because two of my favorite products, Evernote and LinkedIn, have gotten together to help me and you with our business card situation. Now, Evernote has been developing business card scanning technology and building it into Evernote without really... It's been kind of just sitting there on its own, and we haven't used it too much up to now. LinkedIn has had a program called Card Munch, which is quite popular, although I never really dug Card Munch all that much. Turns out that LinkedIn is now dumping Card Munch in favor of a new relationship with Evernote, which just might be a thing of beauty. So stick around. You're going to want to find out what Everin or Linked Note has to offer. All right, Evernote has long been a favorite app of mine, and lately Evernote has been really taking advantage of their document capturing capabilities of the Evernote camera to give us some really creative new functionality. Case in point, in the last couple of months, we have taken a look at the Evernote's ability to capture post-it notes and to automatically file them, and to work with the Moleskine notebook to digitize notes and automatically file those as well by using little stickers that we place on them. And we do all that through the camera app that's built into Evernote. And now LinkedIn and Evernote are getting together to give us yet more functionality to that camera. Let me show you where we go. Oh, let me first of all fire up and start to share this MacBook. Let me first of all fire up and start sharing my iPhone here to give you a look-see. Now, everything that I'm doing right now, we can do on the iPhone right now, not all of it in Android, although you will be able to do this very shortly in Android. They're committed to making it work in Android as well. So, but here's the start. You go into your Evernote settings. You go into the gear settings. We've done this a few times now. You go into the general tab, and here in the general tab, if we scroll down, we can see the camera. And in the camera settings, we can go and we can maintain our settings and we can set it up to capture post-it notes and the Moleskine notebook, all things that we've already looked at and are awesome with Evernote. But there's this new or this additional one here called business cards. And if we tap on the business card link, we can go in and we can connect our Evernote account to our LinkedIn account. And then if we have our saving contacts, it's saving contact info to contacts. We're saving it in a contact form, so it's in like a database form. Then we have the ability to link and to sync our Evernote contacts with our LinkedIn contacts, so we can then automatically move everything over into LinkedIn, which creates all sorts of new opportunities for us. It is awesome. Now, also in here, we have the ability to choose what notebook all of our business cards are saved to. So I just created a notebook called Notebooks. And if you want to, you can tag the notes as well. So, and you can set this up temporarily. So if you were at a conference and you were gathering a whole bunch of business cards at the conference, you could set up a tag to automatically tag everything from that one conference as it comes in, and then change the tag when you move to the next conference. So you have that kind of control at this point using these tools. So they're quite flexible and quite powerful. But now let's take a look at the actual scanning, because bottom line is, if it's not easy to capture the business cards and if it's not clear, if it doesn't do a good job of digitizing and parsing out the information, it's really not that much of a solution, is it? So to use it, we go into the camera. When we go into the camera, up comes, we have it, within our camera, we have the ability to save post-it notes, which we've looked at, photos, documents, using it as a document scanner, and now this new business card one. Now, the cool thing with the business card one is it will look for the business card. It actually creates a little frame for us. So all we have to do is basically get the business card within that frame and go bink. It'll automatically find it. And then it takes a picture. And you don't even have to hold it straight. Do you see how I had it at a slight angle there? But it nevertheless gets it through. And with a business card like this, which is almost all text, look at what a great job it does of parsing out all the information. And look what it's done already. Because it's linked with LinkedIn, it's gone into LinkedIn and it's pulled the photo of the contact that I have. So it's awesome. It's just awesome how that works. But let's see how it works on maybe a little bit more challenging business card. So here's another card that I have. So one, I got to say okay to that. And then, oh, what you have to see here is What it does is, oh, actually, I'm not connected to this person on LinkedIn. It just pulled the information. What it does is it allows us to do a few things at this point here. So you can email your contact information to the person right away. So think about being at that conference. Somebody gives you their business card, you scan it in, and now just with one tap, your email and all of your contact information can be mailed to them so they don't have to scan in your business card. So the connection is made. You can also invite them to connect on LinkedIn if you want to create that connection right away at whatever event you happen to be at as well. So this is a really streamlined process now for bringing people together, for connecting. Now, let's try another card. And this one here is a little more complex, but let's see how it does. Now, you notice what's happening here. Okay, we're just going to move it in. And once it captures it, like grabs it, and it's pretty easy. Okay, this one's more challenging. There's a lot more information on it. The name of the person is not quite as clear. So it missed the company name, which is okay. Oh, it did. No, it didn't get the company name. It pulled a different piece of text for the company name, but it got most of the information. It looks fairly correct. The thing that's important here is you do have to go through in Evernote a little bit later on, and you do have to audit. You have to go through and read through and make sure that everything is correct, because it will make the odd little mistake. It'll turn an I into a 1 and that sort of stuff as it's parsing out the information. So you have to proofread each card. But the cool thing is, you'll see when we go into Evernote in a moment, that the card, the image of the card is there for us as well. So let's try a really challenging card. Oh, sorry, I said done. Let me go back into the camera and let's start it again. It's while it's syncing that. And let's take a much more difficult one now. Let's take this card here, and I want to show you what's going to happen. So this is a very graphically rich card that is quite popular. And look, it's going to, or the style, should I say, is becoming increasingly popular. And look, it's just not getting it at all. It can't capture it. Now, one of the problems is it's a dark background with a dark card. So they tell us to, whenever possible, use a light-colored background with a light dark card and a dark-colored background with a light-colored card. So here we go. Now it's capturing the information. And it didn't really, it cut things off, so I'm going to actually ask it to do it again. And I'm going to trash that one. I'm not going to let it use that one. And I'm going to try it again, maybe working a little bit better angle. There we go. And if there's glare on it, you tilt the camera slightly, and that gets rid of the glare. Okay, so it captured the card here, and it didn't do too bad a job capturing it. Let's see if it gets anything out of it at all. With a card like this, it's not going to get a lot of information. And there's just nothing that we can do about that. Really graphically rich cards are going to be very, very difficult for it to save. So it's just something that we kind of have to put up with. But here's the next step of that process, though, even when you do have that. So bottom line is, if it's an easy card to scan in, if it's an easy card, it's black and white text, it's going to do a great job of capturing the information and putting it into the correct fields. If it's something that's graphically rich like that, the one that we just saw, well, then we're going to have to take on a little bit of the responsibility ourselves. But still, it's a step way in the right direction. So here's my business card notebook right here. So let's just take a look at the three cards that were imported. And I don't have to pick up the card to proofread anymore because I've got the card right here. So I can proofread here just by looking at this information here. So that one is in great shape. This one here, what I might do is I might go in and I might change the company to Speak Your Purpose, which is the name of her company. And I would make the edits right here. So I can go Speak Your Purpose. So I can make all of those changes right here because it's dealing with it as a contact within Evernote. And then finally, this card here, really no useful information at all, but I can read it and I can just go through it. I can type in the information here should I choose to. And so this one here, even though it's still some manual entry, at least again, I don't have to go looking for the card and look back and forth. I can see it all right here on the screen. Now, what will happen because we've synced this with LinkedIn is all of these contacts will then be passed over into LinkedIn as well, and they'll be available to us within LinkedIn, within the contact area of LinkedIn. And that's what I want to show you just quickly right now is the contact area within LinkedIn. And to see your contacts in LinkedIn, you go into your LinkedIn account, you go under the network settings, you go into contacts here, and that brings you into your LinkedIn contacts. And they give you all sorts of background information on all of the different people that you're connected with here in LinkedIn. But where you want to check on the sync, on how it's talking to other applications, is by clicking here on Settings. And within Settings, then, we can go and we can set up the relationships with the other apps. So I've got it set up to actually sync with my Google Contacts, which I think should be another demo. We should be talking about how that all works at another time. And here we also have it synced with Evernote. So there we have what could be the beginning of a really beautiful relationship between LinkedIn and Evernote for us. Well, I think that's awesome. And I should point out that more than just the contacts are going to sync into LinkedIn. All of your notes within Evernote are going to also be available to you to be able to call them up when you're in and when you're communicating within LinkedIn. So it's going to change our workflow quite a bit, at least those of us who decide to embrace this new metaphor. I hope you found today's video to be useful. And I just wanted to point out that there's three ways that you can stay in touch with us should you choose. The first is please subscribe to this channel. That way we let you know right away as soon as we release a new video, which we do just about every day of the week. The second thing you can do is sign up for our newsletter. Now, why would you want to sign up for our newsletter? Because we give you a weekly digest of all of the videos that we produce. As well, you get early notice about all of the different webinars and courses that we put on. And they are all free, so it's well worth your time to sign up for our newsletter. And some of the courses, even though they're free, sell out, so you want to get in early in order to make sure that you can gain access to all of the different training that we put forward here in the Dotto Tech channel. And finally, if you would like to support us in a more tangible way, Dotto Tech is supported by our patrons at Patreon. If you drop by there, you can see how crowdfunding works and how Dotto Tech is the beneficiary of our community stepping up and helping make sure that we can continue producing great, compelling content on an ongoing basis. And with that, I am out of here. I'm Steve Dotto. Have fun storming the castle.